Yep. This is a reintroduction plus some practical perspective. For those of us indeed who are in need of complete vision correction, the only thing that's required is a lens that's genuinely objective, and a minute of your time to wrap your mind around divine perception. Cause even the most mindless and spiritually blind can be the spectator in a theater of God's magnificent designs. If you would incline your ears and your eyes to these sounds and these signs, we would attempt to rightly refine and align your crooked sight, but we not implying that a sunset or an ocean can begin to set in mind when the Son of Man began to set in redemptive motion. For morals, meaning, and devotion, heart, mind, and emotion, substance, significance, and truth cannot be explained or reduced to a big bang explosion. Because his character and nature cannot be known through natural revelation, or shown through random acts or figments of your imagination. We, the beautiful eulogy, attempt to communicate audibly and visually to help you hear and see the glory of God clearly.
Of your love everlasting. I start where I finish, pick it back up where I left it. I'm just a man of unclean lips. I've only seen a glimpse, but everywhere I look I see his fingerprints. All things were made through him. We received his revelation, so we reflect it when we breathe. And the concepts we conceive are born of spiritual seed, manifest in a material realm as musical composition. The rhythm of heartbeats transformed by the gospel and godly wisdom. I'm an instrument of his mercy, unworthy but still he uses me. The beauty of the eulogy, through his death we are truly free. Free indeed. The condemnation and the bondage of our sin was abolished on the cross, and he alone accomplished it. God made himself known, exposing his own nature and his glory through his Son, the revelation of our Savior, the fullness of God born in human form, deity in the flesh. We need a spirit and the word to open our eyes so we can see correct the vital lens.